How's it going? Funzo here, it's also...
What a fucking big Soyo rap is full all fucking day.
Yeah! Let's go, man! Make some noise!
OGs. We got the OGs. We got the fucking OGs, man.
18 months in the works. There's been some financial differences, let's say. But they both compromise, and it's $500,000 each they've agreed to. To my left, it's Nugget! You are
Nugget! I'm my motherfucking right!
The old fucking G Raptor, the MC motherfucker.
Two of the best in Ireland, two of the best in Dublin, two of the best has ever done it. Let's hear it for the lads and let's have a classic battle. Go on!
Let's go, lads! Let's go now.
Okay. It's
2006. Fuck, I fucked up that line. You shouldn't have used the same prayers as when you ducked us the last time. Current crop doesn't resemble the scene that I've known. So if you think you're the king now, then I guess I'm seizing your throne like I'm in a season of throne. Shit, I'm 15 seconds in. I already feel like I'm home. Yeah! And I might rate you right now, but don't think you're at the top though. You were looking after my house while I was away, turning on and off the lights and feeding me dogs, bro. If the king's landing on this stage, then I guess this is my spot, so. Cause I'm the bastard that was out in the cold and deserves the throne like Jon Snow. Yes! And if the king of that past me prime and it's Raptor's time, he has to shine. I did more battles than him in less than half the time. Look at the buzz you have from your battles. Look at the buzz I have from mine. My debut stays viewed more than all your battles combined. You might. You spit bullshit filler, random punchlines, but the fans rate you in comparison with guys you're standing beside. I'll damage your pride. Without me, this battle wouldn't have half of the hype. Your mates are only here for a rare chance to see me battling live. I only battled for 2 years, haven't battled in 5. But I guess physically or lyrically, it's harder for Raptor to shine when he's standing behind a shadow this wide. And I don't give a fuck if I'm not in your top 5 rappers. I was top 5 when top 5 mattered.
Yes!
Let's go, Norman! Let's go! Me, Rossall, Jambo, Red, Nash, I'm from that DFI original 2010 class! Yes! The next 5 will body you, next 5 will give you your best match, the next 5, you'd have probably beaten, but they only did 1 or 2 and I never let them. Rossall would own you, you know you'd be smashed. Use that aggressive approach against Jambo, you know you'd be slapped. You and Robbie would learn a thing or two about 2-on-2s from Boney and Nash, and you learn a thing or two about growing a tash. Because when I was taking on anybody, killing them no problem, and quitting was no option, what the fuck were you doing, Dan? Sitting at home watching. Couldn't survive in my era, so just play a position. Cause now I'm restarting the scene like a failed GTA mission. Now listen, you couldn't win this battle even if I wasn't trying. Even if I lost my mind, forgot all my rhymes, said I couldn't make it cause I'm in Galway lying. All me bars show a Facebook video online. You couldn't win this battle if every judge was John Coyne. That's how you do a round. Punchlines, bars in the presence. So why don't we just call it 1-0 and I'll start on my second.
That was sick.
Knocking doors for dogs, I want that set straight. Yes. And I'm supposed to be fond of Gary, that means I cared more about dogs than I did my best mate. And another thing, I gave young rappers crap, disgraceful act. So if you, him, or anyone has anything to say for that, I'm not going to say a goddamn thing, I'm going to take it, lad. See, I was looking at the cards in my hand, I misplaced the pack. I'm no better than any rapper in here. Shamrock on a heart and a spade for tracks. I'm pulling diamonds out the ass when you place your back. Am I a draw for these cards? Quote Dre for that.
You've been trying to be the king, but the ace is back.
Your last battle was me debut. Should I correct myself?
What have you been doing the last 6 years? Going, you know, for Ben's help.
You were a legend after O'Shea, but you took that ball and left. Weren't about to let yourself spread the wealth, and you became the mighty Mick. Moy and Mick, this legend's dead since 2012. Yes. 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 Dead for 6 years. Yes. 6 years. Can hand the mind, I'm fantasize, I'm past this point and amplified. You had your point, I'm back in words, I'm back in toys. Monkey lines, I'm Frankie Boyle, I'm a mad scientist round here. The show to walk to bring a dumb cunt back from the dead, I'm Dr. Frankenstein. Yeah. 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 I look up to you, bro. First day was shit, I wanted you to get a verse in. I was 19, 20, 22, I'm not certain. I was amazed to meet you at a show back then. Before we opened doors, that's when I heard you rehearsing, and that proved beyond all doubt what they said. It really is a letdown when you fucking meet your hero in person. He was talking about an electric picnic. Had the crowd pumped on some raw, energetic punch shit that real rappers come with when real rappers run lips. Not you. Us two. You brought one party track to a festival. That's worthless, you dumb prick. The crowd were clearly hoping your bits were done quick. I'm lucky that I got to make it back in one bit. Expecting me to carry him, he break me back with one tick. Speaking of being carried, Gary, all the braggadocious DFI shit he did, you are some dick. Use Reds are for a piece of pie, no DFIs are done with. No. All his UK views on UK battles, you think they were for his done with? That was an idiot abroad on cam because his best friends run shit. So maybe have a think. Ooh, maybe have a think before you try and say you're done shit, because Gary Carl Pilkin think of flying saying bullshit. Yes. Yes. I've been known to keep a joke. I like a joke, but that's not right. I'm not in this for the crack, I've got no glass or plastic pipes. I've been jabbing right for bragging rights. I came to beat him to the punch, unorthodox, Pacquiao and Hatton shy. Call it blockbuster, call it murder in the fourth, call it over in the second, because he's going on his back tonight. He's gotten Hatton down now. Finished fat and looking back on life. Yes. I used to bully other kids at hopscotch. Yeah. Don't walk around in odd socks. Boxers with hot rocks. Broken earphones and robbed watch. Rob's watch. Bob Feet are looking for a night out with Top Notch. I'm a hot scotch, good enough a shaker to spill me on the floor like a top prop. I used to be 80% banned round here. And if I'm absent-minded, lost prof, that's because you're pointless at these bars and in Ireland that's a lost cause.
Let's go! Bringing on me DFI days, that's a fucking awful round. At least some of us had glory days to fucking talk about. Talking about Top Notch, you're saying for death, because I know you're shitting it over that paternity test. Shout out Rory and Podge. Yes. I have to give them a mention. But we set this battle up with some different intentions, because everyone here cares about you then. This is an intervention. Please lock the fuck out of Facebook before you spout another ridiculous sentence. Because you rant on Facebook when you're pissed off at the scene. I'll be on the Irish battle page, all is serene. People talking about battles. Mostly all are agreeing with suddenly, hold on, what am I seeing? A notification about a comment from Dean pops up across the top of my screen and I'm thinking I'm going to need it. Michael Jackson, popcorn meme. Yes! But then the popcorn goes stale and you're still typing. I go to bed. I go up the next day. And you're still right. Nobody's throwing bait out, but you're still biting. There's no one left to fight with, and you're still fighting. Because everyone else involved has already sorted it out. But we're reading you replying to yourself on Facebook. I have had it up to here with your nonsensical, long-winded online disses. I'd rather read 50 posts of Dylan Coleman shite on you know that's cheap because before they even step on stage, it's already on train. They know that they're beat. And then you get all up in their face and overly mean, but it doesn't even matter because it's already over, Dean. But I don't think you should try that approach today because it's only me. Because I want you to know I've got a fucking police record. Don't stand so close to over battle rap and it made you look quite thick because if you had good punchlines you wouldn't have to punch like this. See, I never have to punch guys or thump my fist. When I spit a punchline they punch like shit. And I don't give a fuck if you don't like my Game of Thrones bars. Bars about comic books. Woo! So hard. Even named yourself after a comic book. Don't say it was the Norse god because if it wasn't for the comic book you wouldn't know what Thor was. And this one's not for you. For those who said me style stated, what's your problem now, cunts? Hear me style stated. All your L ones!
Yeah. He's back! He's back!
Let's go!
Let's go!
Let's go!
All very good, but he's talking about Facebook statuses. That's the least of my problems. I'm so cheap, I've been strung out on speed. I had a coke addiction. I don't even talk about the weed addiction. I used to knock doors for a living. I bummed for a living, bro. I needed this and needed fixing. Do me a favour, me mate. Put some effort in and hoard if you ain't at Disney. You wanna dig up all that dirt and you might just find yourself because you're the cunt who's ancient history. That is why I really hope if you are gonna come, you come correct. I'm a scar and a crazy bitch's shoulder, just that old cliche, I'm a cut above the rest. Ooh, I'm a goal in sudden death. I'm gonna kill this healthy adult made Max stop his heart like I'm fucking sudden death. Out to represent me team because I love the bloody crest. Could have said Cassetta came to dig a mine for gold. I'm gonna go home empty handed because nugget's nothing left. Put it all wound up and thank you really for that. Do you ever hear him talking shit? You can't even ask this man a question without him getting well and go. Honestly, I'm not in glasses. Don't get into me again. Again, a dog, I hear you barking. Why don't you join Team AWOL? Perfect Irish team. That's Mickey Bow and me. It's you, me, Marley, Carl, Bobby. Think about the shit. Use me and Hardly. We're two different types of Irish drama. Without a Barney, ain't no party. This is Ronan Keenan being broken up by Keenan with a Derby. Bro's fucking Hardy books against the wind that shakes the barley. And he even claimed it. An Irish legend. I'm standing here slagging fully grown men. Could I be an Irish legend? Fuck no! I never thought it's real. Hard enough just trying to walk the streets of Ireland where the foggy Jew bodies fills. Patrick Bonner, James Connolly, Michael Collins, Ronnie Drill. Yeah. How many more do we pay homage to? Dude ain't a legend. Dude ain't even Z-list. You really want to talk it through or walk it through and you'll be feeling buried and exposed like your rock Sinead O'Connor's do. Anybody copping them down? Use the Irish angles that I didn't use on Double L or on Seuss. To simply point out that my man ain't the same kid. He got loads of cheap kicks on some back in the day shit. Like, anybody recall when he battled O'Shea over here? Because O'Shea was from Liverpool at the time, he'd be practically hated. No, O'Shea. Maybe passively rated. Either way,
nice.
You knew what blatant anger would take it. So you said, you Brits fucked that bunch of up and took that language. The same happy O'Shea did. I mean, I know in this game, most biggie, most famous, but for one jolly skills battle to achieve all that, even you'd have to say it is a pretty bold statement. Picture O'Shea or Marty McFly on some Back to the Future shit. Fucking back in time to find the language and take it. Yes. Showing up in 1916, all Terminator skills with a hamburger naked. Cop on, nugget. That would take for you to get the win on Irish soil. Any chance that you face Brits? You ain't a load of looks. We don't need you for that work. Fuck on back to your day shift. Okay. I'm gonna change this up for rapping sake. Hit him with a stunner like the rattlesnake. Beat him black and blue, you bet black and red. Like get you led at Council Gas Estate. What was that? Talent, bro. You'd never know. Your average mate. Call me and the lads AWOL, decorators. Call us poster boys, cause Rory stuck us up there just to paper over cracks you made. What I'm
God's name is with the tracks you make. Ever hear this refugee song? ever hear that shit? Refugees, a welcome here. Refugees, a welcome here. I was thinking, Lord Jesus, someone help me here. I mean, yeah. Forget the fucking music, but it's amazing. But you want to help the refugees out? You live in a tent on a high cliff. And let the refugees have your home. No, Mr. Nappy Head ain't got the vocab, and you ain't exactly white clips, so fuck on and leave the refugee camp alone, bro. Oh.
Crazy, man.
So this is a true story. So me and Dino once teamed up in a 2-on-2.
Yeah.
And I guess the big question is, versus who and who? Masayo and Robbie, and honestly, bodied them in one round. But was it worth it with you and Rob that you broke all of the trust down? Don't even stand up there! Did he leave your WhatsApp friends group? Take his Xbox back from your house? Does he stick his earphones in when he sees you getting on the bus now? This is a true story. Remember Electric Picnic? You were fucked from the joints and basically off your head. About 9:30 in the evening, Dino had to be whisked off to bed. But we still had to perform again. We were kicking on till the death, and it's safe to say Bushy Braids, he wasn't impressed. So just before we left, he went off to your tent, unzipped, grabbed your feet, dragged you off by the legs, and forced you to play the most awful of sets. Remember that? When your voice was all squeaky and sore like shit? It's funny, being stoned in your tent just made you more high-pitched. This is a true story. And if it's harsh, it's true, but I have to do this, because Raptor's clueless, your album's useless, because Alan Newman carried you on half the tunes now, that's producing. And I don't consider the advocates movement actual music, because if you call the main track Kamikaze, you're stupid. Because the name Kamikaze is hit missing itself. I mean, the Kamikaze might hit its target, but it's guaranteed that you're killing yourself. This is a true story. Point it. When you didn't turn up last time, I thought, bro, you're a cunt. Because I look forward to that battle for probably over a month.
So do we!
Well, you did it for the Dogs Trust, and that was an admirable and great career. I fucking love dogs, man. I love when I find a friendly dog and I take him near and I rub under his neck and play with his ear. Tim, you texted me and said I'm not coming, I can't make it, I swear, and I just want you to know, I kicked the fucking dog in the face on the way! You are shit at that job, because they all saw you coming like, fuck it, it's the dog, man. Because you fucking drive around in a Dumb and Dumber dog van. Listen to the dog rap, wanna be a dog chap, Snoop Doggy Dog, DMX, screaming, where my dog's at? Are you upset because I slagged the little doggies and they laugh? Check my old battle, so I already killed a Nate dog and a collie in the past. If you really love dogs, then I know where this chap has to get me. Because I'm a battle vet, and vets, well, they're the dog's natural enemy. And when I say I'm a vet, I don't mean how long that nug's around. I mean that you might think that you're an animal till I come along and push it down. And this is a true story. Spitting all these obscure facts and loads of references doesn't make you so intelligent. That's not bars over jokes, that's just randomness over relevance. And I know that these onset frowns are sometimes spit at the hugest of costs, but this is a true story. You just lost.
Let's go, Raptor! Come on, man! Let's go!
Raptor! You actually had the neck to talk about my song. Stop the clock. Look at you. There's stuff you do for fucking views. Think about the creativity of this, like a teaspoon, the motherfucker, when it comes to Irish tune, Dublin tune. When McGregor sparked Aldo, I was half expecting Dublin tune.
Yeah, honestly.
Listen to how you rap. It's not exactly Fat Joe who's gonna answer back with that flow. Where the rapping at, bro? You at blatant disadvantage at a handicap, bro. I'm in the driver's seat. And I kept him in the car so we could park in the handicap zone. I'm a killer in this shit. I'm Dr. Death if you're from England, Broken Hair if you're Scott. I'm Leatherface if you're from Texas, Charlie Manson. But God, Jesus, that's me, bro. That means I'm Judas. I'll set him up for crucifixion just so I can have a spliff and stare at the cross. And when the crows come to peck you, I'll be trying to cheer them on without scaring them off. I'm not going to stand up here and say, where are me props? But I've been
tearing up the scene from the moment that I touched this shit. Who here has forgot? You want to tell me he's your founding father? Well, I got some shit to deal once I buried your pops. I've been hearing, I've been hearing digs from Sonny.
Relax, it's justified.
It was also justified when I'm hearing it from Paz, but I've even been mimicked you if you've been hearing from Scott.
Yo!
That's why I'm back. Shield, armor, sword. I brought the heavy metal with me because I'm ready and I'm ready to rock. What Dylan said, nah, I'm a digger down with little hit to turn up the shot. Let's take this back to where we were as a touch, right? Hide or go sheepy like you're there with your dog. You'll be found out by a 10 count ready or not. Knocked out by a punch count ready. The box now, whether I'm crossing lines or whether I'm passing borders. I came to clean house, Kim and Ivy. Spend some time harassing hoarders. Yeah. You need to understand, you missed your boat. Your ship says sail for calmer waters. I'm the general around here now. Poor his old Joss Comer, Shoka Maravi. I say this one time off scale, get out of those who start before us. For him, it's Clay Joss. Time to go, old soldier. Those are fucking marching orders. Yeah! Yeah! About being a nicer person. Let's talk to him about being a nicer rapper. No matter what happens here today, you should go down in history. Fact. If looking back in 20 years and this shit is an industry, the legacy you have should let your children live in infamy. Fact. You should be on Mock the Week. It's comic relief, isn't it? He is. But the rapping's gotten sad nowadays. See, they listen when you talk about the homeless shit, but not for skill, for sympathy. Sympathy. And that's why anything that anybody says don't mean a thing to me. I ask you not to listen. They like you so much that if you play piano woefully, they'll say release a symphony. That is today. The shit is just a sin to speak. Situation ain't real, it's animation. Battle rap with Dopsy, it's a late with a date release of Simpson C. I prefer the truth to simple speech. Be happy when you think of me, because honestly, existing these, I probably could kill the weak, but deep down, you a man. I know you're better real than trickery. What I'm trying to say is, I hear people mention it all noisy, you're fond of Stephen King, it seems. Well, he needs to forget the audience at tonight's horror show and stick with me, because you've been lying back watching this dying act. I took the rights off King himself like I'm relieving him of misery. What you have to wind me up for, guys? I loved you, man. Once you got me hot and bothered. I got one more thing to say, you cunt. I'm really fucking honored. Yeah!